The following program was provided by an independent producer solely responsible for its content. The opinions expressed do not necessarily represent the views of this station, its staff, board of directors, or underwriters.
Welcome to another edition of our program, CHW In Action, with your CHW, your host, Rafael Calderon. Now, as usual, I like to say that CHW stands for Community Health Worker, and the name of this TV show is CHW In Action because I'm always in action trying to bring you, my community of Nashua, and of the entire state of New Hampshire, and the whole New England region, and beyond. I try to bring you new ways in which to, or introduce you to new ways in which to live a healthier lifestyle via creating an ideal lifestyle. I believe that all of us should live our lives every day working on creating our ideal lifestyles. And in order to do that, we have to be living a healthy lifestyle. See what I mean? Now, I can tell you that when a person is living their ideal lifestyle, that does not mean that life is perfect, that they have a perfect lifestyle. The key about life is that we're always going to have problems and challenges, and the key is not to let these problems and these challenges get the best of us. The key is to confront these challenges and these problems and use them to grow as a human being, as a spiritual being. And what I try to do, my work as a community CHW or as a community health worker, so you'll hear me say that you will hear me a lot saying community health worker instead of community health worker, CHW, because it's shorter and it's just, to me, it sounds cool. Okay, now you know what the name of the show stands for, CHW Forever. Now let me tell you that if you are new to watching my show, or if you happen to click on channels, the TV station now at this time, and you find me on TV and you haven't seen me before, or if you are someone that used to see my TV show before, you would know that I have not been on TV, I have not done a TV show since July. I took the whole summer off to go on what I call a journey to find a way to be more useful to my community of Nashua and of Manchester, New Hampshire. And when I say beyond the New England region, and as you know, the New England region is composed of six states, you know, from Maine to New Hampshire to Vermont, Massachusetts, Rhode Island, and Connecticut. I can tell you honestly that my work as a community health worker, as a CHW, has touched every one of these states. Not so much in Vermont. Vermont, I've only done, let's just say, because I don't want to speak of anything that is not factual, that I cannot prove, in case someone had any questions. Vermont has been kind of indirect in my line of work. But I can tell you, and I can actually have history of having work in New Hampshire, then in Maine, and then going to training as a CHW to Rhode Island and being basically paid for, I can't think of a better way, from the state of Connecticut. And then I have been offered to teach these classes, which I'll talk about the healthy classes that I teach. I've been offered to have them, to teach them in Massachusetts. So basically I have touched every state in one way or another with these classes, with my work. And now I want to find a way that I can bring it beyond. So last year, I had to go pick up one of my nieces, one of my angels. I call all my nieces and nephews angels because they remind me what life is supposed to be about. Life is supposed to be about dedicating it to somebody else, dedicating it to family and to loved ones. And that's why my nieces and nephews, I call them my angels, not because they're perfect, but because they motivate me to be a better person, to be a better uncle, right? So let us start this TV show. So let me say again, welcome to our TV show called CHW in Action with your host, your CHW, Rafael Calderon. Again, I will mention that I have been away from the TV studio since July, and I have basically been working in a new field or a different field, the field of insulation, well, it's more like weatherization. And I was working as an insulation technician, and everyone that knows me knows that I'm not good with my hands. So I'm grateful that the company gave me an opportunity to be part of their team, but they knew and I knew that I was never gonna be like the best insulation technician. My goal was to become an energy auditor. And I thought that if I did that job well enough for long enough, then I would be able to transition into an energy auditor. However, as time went by, I came to realize that in order for me to become an energy auditor, I had to go back to school and I had to get a BPI license. And BPI, I forget what it stands for, but if you know what I'm talking about, then you know what it is. And if not, I can look it up for you. If you have any questions, I can look it up and tell you. However, finding out that I needed this license and that it would take me longer, and I was working outside in the winter, and I really didn't like it. I don't like the cold weather. I liked the job. I didn't mind the job, because if you know about insulation, you know that it can be a tough job, not the cleanest job, kind of a difficult job. However, it's a beautiful thing when you finish doing the work and you see how our home has become more energy efficient. It's good for the planet. It saves money for the homeowner or the business owner. I think that every facility should be weatherized. And if you want information about how to do it, I would be happy to put you in contact with my new former employer, because I did have to leave that job behind so that I could study to become an energy auditor, and so that I can come back to my passion. My passion is this TV show. My passion is being a community health worker to do CHW work. And that is how I come to you. I come to you with a little story, okay? If you can see, I have toys as usual. I have toys in my table. I'm gonna tell you a little bit about them, right? So that you know how I have been using them, how I intend to use them to bring my services, not only back to Nashua, because I love Nashua. And I like to point out that I am from Manchester. I live in Manchester, New Hampshire, and I love Manchester. However, I have always felt that Nashua is my home. I have always felt Nashua as my home, because in Nashua, I have accomplished a lot of things. I have met so many great people that have supported my work. And in Manchester, I know a lot of people, but I'm sad to say that I haven't found the same type of support. Now, having said that, I would love to bring my services to Manchester as well. What I'm trying to point out is that although I do not live in Nashua, Nashua is my community. And that's why I'm coming back to do this TV show instead of trying to restart this TV show in Manchester. Because if you remember, I told you at the beginning of the program that I haven't done that show since July. Okay? So let me tell you. So back in, and I'll tell you the exact date. In September 30th of 2014, I received what I call a spiritual experience. I was having a really bad day. I was struggling with this thing called E-Verify. And for those of you that don't know what E-Verify is, it's a program that was implemented by people, I have to put it that way, people or politicians that wanted to make things difficult for immigrants in this country. And even though I'm a U.S. Army veteran, even though I am a U.S. citizen, I was found to be non-compliant with E-Verify. And E-Verify is basically when you apply for a job and you mark that you're a U.S. citizen, then that job checks your information with the Social Security office. And your information has to match, your ID information has to match the record. So I said I'm a U.S. citizen because I have been a U.S. citizen for so many years. But if they have you as a permanent resident only in their system, that information does not match. So what they do is they give you, I forget what it is now, 8 or 10 business days to prove that you are a USA resident in order for you to maintain employment. And if you cannot prove it, then you cannot work. You have to basically start the process of becoming a U.S. citizen. Now, the issue with me is that back in 2006, I had what I call a downfall. In 2006, what used to be an ideal lifestyle for me became a living nightmare, where I lost my home, I lost my former fiance, and I lost all my assets, and basically I lost everything. My life became like a country music. It was a very sad situation. When I lost a home, and let me just make sure, and I want to make sure that I say this correctly, I did not lose the home because the bank took it away from me. I chose to give it back because my mindset was not right. My wheel of life was unbalanced. And in those days, I didn't know what the wheel of life philosophy was. I didn't know what being unbalanced was. All I knew is that everything that I had worked so hard for was now gone. And the woman that I thought, well, that I loved so much turned out to be not who I expected her to be. So things had to end, right? I didn't know how to recover from that, so I went into what people call depression, a chronic depression. And that is at that time when I basically, I would never say that I gave up on life, but I did lose my desire to be useful to others. That's what happened in 2006, and it went on until 2009. But I'm coming back to you. I'm telling you all this because in 2006, when I lost that home, my home, in my home, I lost my U.S. citizenship certificate and my U.S. passport. So I have no way to prove, I had no way to prove that I was a U.S. citizen except with my license and my Social Security card. When it came to jobs that require me to satisfy E-Verify, they wouldn't accept my license or my Social Security card. They wanted either my U.S. citizenship or my U.S. passport. And since I didn't have them, they said I would have to start the process all over, right? And that could take years and a lot of money that I didn't have. But I'm telling you, and this is why I believe in what I'm doing, I believe that God is on my side, because when I went to, let's say, USIS or immigration officials, they gave me a very hard time to fix this problem. And I got to the point in which I said, you know what, forget it. I give up. If this country is going to be this way, then I might as well go back home to the Dominican Republic. I was at a point where I wasn't thinking anymore about building a better life. I just want the stress to be over, right? And that is, well, to end the story, let me just say that through my own work, my own research, I found a way to fix that problem. And also, and that's what that spiritual experience came to be, I found a way to fix that problem without having to deal with USCIS, without immigration. Because due to the fact that I was a US citizen, I was a US soldier, my information was recorded. And this is a beautiful thing. This is why I believe in community. And I believe in community as a unit, as one, as everybody in a community being one, right? One mind, one spirit, one energy, divided into different people, but all united by the same thing, right? So I told you that this happened to me. I lost all my stuff, my US citizenship stuff in 2006. I was unable to find professional, well-paying work up until 2014. And this is when I had the spiritual experience, right? So I'm sorry I had to give you all that information so it makes sense to you. So what happens is that in September 30th of 2014, I have found this excellent job as a marketplace assistant, and I was going to help people get health insurance. That's when the Obamacare kicked in, one of the most wonderful things that President Obama did, in my opinion, right? When I got that job paying well, it was part-time, it would allow me to work on my, at that time I called my business Kiskeya Energy Solutions, and it has always been about the same people, helping people finding solutions to their problems. That's how I promoted it, right? So I was going to be able to follow my passion to be useful to others at that time as a job developer / life coach through Kiskeya Energy Solutions. And I was the happiest camper when I found that job. And then I got the call from the HR of that organization telling me that I needed to satisfy the requirements of E-Verify, and that I was a U.S. citizen or I would have to give up that job. I had 8 to 10 business days to prove that to them. Well, to make a long story short, I was able to do that in the most interesting way. I was driving, that day that I went to USCIS, the USCIS office in Bedford, New Hampshire. And there I was told again that I had no choice but to start the whole process over, to become a U.S. citizen again, to take the test, to pay the money, to order the passport, so on and so forth, and then I could reactivate myself or rectify the situation with the Social Security Administration, which is the one that still had me as a permanent resident, right? Because what happens is when you come to this country, you become a permanent resident for 5 years, or you have to wait 5 years and then apply for U.S. citizenship, and then when you become a U.S. citizen, they take away your permanent resident card, and they give you a new apply for a U.S. passport. Because I was in the U.S.